Welcome to online classes of Sri Mahavir International School. So students, today I am going to teach you English grammar chapter number 1, kinds of sentences. Okay, let's start our classes. Your chapter number 1 is kinds of sentences. Before starting the chapter, let's take a quick revision that what is sentence. In English grammar, we learn that a group of words which make a complete sense and a meaningful thought is called sentences. But how we create the sentence? Let me clear. In English, letter. Letter is very smallest unit of English language. Letter is very smallest unit of English language. If I write here A, A is a letter. And when I make a group of letter, apple, this is a word. So we can say a group of letters make a word. And when these group of words make a complete sense and having a meaningful thought, that is called sentence. Let me clear. An apple in a day keeps a doctor away. So here I am writing a group of words which make a complete sense, that an apple in a day keeps a doctor away. So this sentence having a group of words as well as have some meaningful thought or have some sense. And this meaningful thought and sense is called a clear statement. So what is sentence? A sentence is a group of words which having a sense, meaningful thought or having a clear statement is called sentence. One very important thing is that these sentences always begins with a capital letter as well as ends with any punctuation mark. If I write any sentence in this way, apple, good, but is not. This is also a group of words, but you cannot find here any meaningful thought or a statement. One thing is that. Second thing, you cannot see that this sentence is begin with a capital letter or end with any punctuation mark. So this group of word is not a sentence. So to recognize or identify the clear definition of the sentences, that a sentence is a group of word which make a complete thought or having a statement and begins with a capital letter or ends with punctuation mark. Here we find full stop. Full stop also called in English language a period. So I hope beta, you just get the quick revision of that what is sentence. So students, now we learn about the 6 kinds of sentences according to English grammar. In English grammar, there are 6 kinds of sentences that are, number 1 is assertive. Various book having a different name of this assertive type of or kind of sentence. Sometime in some books we find assertive, declarative, affirmative and simple. You can find any one of these names in your book. In yours book, we can find assertive, but in some book we can find declarative, affirmative and simple. So don't get confused. These all type are same in a first kind of sentence. So the first type of sentence is assertive, declarative, affirmative and simple. The second kind of sentence is here, negative sentence. Third is interrogative sentence. Fourth is imperative sentence. Fifth is exclamatory sentence. And sixth is optative sentence. So in English grammar, there are six type of sentences that are assertive, negative, interrogative, imperative, exclamatory and optative. Now we are do the separate explanation of each kind of sentence. Let's begin with a first kind, that is declarative. That is declarative sentence. What is that? Declarative type of sentence having a simple statement. Like in our class, you are doing the conversation with your friends, with your teachers, in a simple way or in a simple statement. These type of sentences are called declarative sentence. Let me clear how. I am playing in the park. So this is a simple statement, and this simple statement having some thought, okay, have a sense. So this type of sentence is called declarative sentence, as well as assertive, affirmative and simple. One thing I'm repeating in my teaching in my classes also, that sentence always begins with capital letter or ends with any punctuation mark. But in the declarative sentence, we find full stop at the end of the sentence, and this full stop is also called period in English language. Get it? So this is the first type of sentence, that is declarative sentence. Now come to the next one, that is negative sentence. That is negative sentence. So students, what is negative sentence? Negative sentence express any negation in the sentence that represent by some words, that is not, no, never, forbid, okay. So when we find these words in the sentence which expresses negative sense in the sentence, that is called negative sentence. Let me clear you. She does not complete her homework. So what we find here? Here a statement, but this statement expressing the negative sense in the sentence. When the statement expressing any negative sense, this type of sentence is called negative sentence. One more thing is very important, that when you get the declarative or the simple sentence and you convert it into a negative, how we do? Let me teach you. I am writing here, I eat an apple. Why I am saying you again and again talking about an apple? Because right now corona is running, and we have to generate our immunity system. So beta, you have to take one apple in a day. That's why I'm using here apple. So I eat an apple. So I make it into a negative form. How we make it? When we change any sentence into any negative form, what we do? First we identify in the sentence that which tense is run here. Can you identify which tense is run here? I taught you in your previous class. In this sentence, we find verb first form. We do not find here any auxiliary verb. So what we do? We just find that this is a present indefinite tense. I also taught you that what is the syntaxes of the sentence. So when we change positive into negative, what we do? We just write here I. In the syntax, we find after the subject, we use any auxiliary verb. I use with do. To make the negative, we write here not eat an apple. So this sentence is converted into the negative by the declarative. Is tarah se humne negative positive ko negative mein convert kiya. I hope beta you get it, how we change into positive and negative. And what is exactly the negative sentence? Negative sentence, when the sentence expresses any negative senses in the sentence. Now come to the third type of sentence or kind of sentence, that is interrogative. interrogative. The spelling is very long and sometimes my student find it is difficult. So the interrogative spelling is interrogative. Interrogative sentence. What is interrogative sentence now? In your class, you just asking me sometime, ma'am, may I go to washroom? Ma'am, may I come in? Ma'am, what we are going to do? So you are asking me some question, and this asking of question having a sense and expressing itself as a interrogative type of sentences. So what is interrogative sentence? When we ask the question in the sentence way, that is called interrogative sentence. But beta, how we identify it? We identify it that these type of sentence begins with WH word as well as auxiliary verbs. So interrogative type of sentences begins with WH word as well as auxiliary verb. Let me clear it. How we identify it in the types of sentences? What are you playing? So I'm asking a question to someone that what are you playing? So it is an interrogative sentence. How come we know? Because it is begins with WH word as well as and with one question mark, and this question mark is a punctuation mark. I'm repeating my words that always sentence begins with a capital letter. Okay, but in the interrogative sentence we find WH word as well as these type of sentences ends with one punctuation mark. That punctuation mark is question mark. Okay, let me give you one more example. Are you playing football? So I'm asking another question to someone. Are you playing football? This is a manner of a question, but how we identify it? Because here we know that this is a beginning of auxiliary verb or ends with a punctuation mark, that is question mark. So when you get lot of sentences and identify the interrogative type of sentence, what you find? First you read the sentence properly, then you find the expression, then you find WH word in the beginning and auxiliary verb at the beginning, and at the last you find the question mark. In this way you can easily identify the interrogative type of sentences. I hope beta you get the third type of sentence by me. Now come to the fourth type of sentence, that is imperative type of sentence. That is imperative sentence. What is it? Imperative sentence. Let me clear what is imperative sentence. I just tell you, go out from my class, bring one glass of water, please give me your pen, don't play on the road. So I'm speaking here some sentences. What type of sentences these are? These type of sentences are imperative sentence, because in these sentences we find the expression of order, command, suggestion and request. So when in the sentence we find the expression of order, command, request and suggestion are called imperative sentence. Let me clear. I just write here first, that is please give me your pen, full stop. Next, don't play on the road, full stop. Then go out from my class, from my house कर देते हैं यहाँ पे क्योंकि अभी आपको क्लास से बाहर नहीं जाना. Go out from my class. Then stand up. So here I am writing four sentence. Please give me your pen. So what expression you find here? We find here request. So this is a imperative sentence. Don't play on the road. When you are playing outside your home, what your mother give you suggestion or advice? That don't play on the road. So this is a suggestion or advice. Okay, advice we can say, better than suggestion, it is advice. Okay, go out from my house. This is order or command, or stand up is a command. So when in the sentence we find the expression of request, advice, suggestion, order or command are called imperative type of sentences. So beta, in this way you just learn about the four type of sentence, that is imperative sentence. Now come to the next one, that is fifth type, that is exclamatory. Exclamatory, 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 exclamatory sentence. What is exclamatory sentence? Sometime you are very happy and you are express your feeling by the sentence. Let hooray, we won the match. What expression we are giving here? That you are very happy. And if you have any favorite thing with you and you lost it, that I have very special book with me, but last 4-5 days before I lost it, so I'm very sad, so I'm expressing, oh, I lost my book. So when we express any strong feeling or a sadness by the sentence, and these type of sentences are called exclamatory sentence. What these type of sentences called? Exclamatory type of sentences, which express strong feeling, that was sudden, that will be a sudden, that will be happiness, or will be sometime a grief, sorrow or sadness. Let me clear. Hooray, I won the match. So I am expressing here my feeling that I am very happy with the word hooray, as well as the use of exclamatory or exclamation mark. But oh, I lost my favorite book. So what type of expression I am giving here? I am sad, so I use here one word, that is O, and using exclamation mark. Beta, these type of words are also called interjection. I will clear this topic in the next class. It is also included in your syllabus. But to learn the exclamatory sentence, we read the sentence properly, learn the expression, what type of expression is here, and what type of feeling is expressing in the sentence, that it should be a happy or sad. So in the first sentence, hooray, I won the match, I am expressing here that I am very happy. In the second sentence, I lost my favorite book. So what expressions are here? That I am very sad. So when in the sentence we are expressing any sudden feeling, which should be a happy or sometime be a sad, are called exclamatory type of sentences. So beta, I hope you just get the fifth type of sentence, that is exclamatory sentence. Now the last type of sentence is optative. Optative type of sentences, that is optative sentence. Sixth type of sentences, optative sentence. What is optative sentence? It is not included in your course, but when you are moving in the higher classes, you just get this separation of this kind of sentence. So I am clearing you in this session that optative sentence having the expression of wish or a curse. Wish or curse. What is wish? When you are having a birthday, you just come to your ma'am or just touch the feet of your any elder one, what they give you? They give you a blessing that may God bless you, be happy, always smiling. So these all are the wishing or expressing goodwill for anyone. But someone giving a curse, right now we are just giving a curse to corona, that go corona go. What we are expressing? That go to hell. So this is a curse for someone. So in the sentence, we are expressing the wishing as well as the curse are called optative type of sentence. Let I am talking about may God bless you. So what I am giving you? I am giving you a wishing or the blessing. So this is an optative type of sentence and go to hell. Right now we all are just praying for the corona that go to hell. Okay, so you will be come back to this school. So go to hell is a curse to someone. When we get any blessing or curse in the sentence, these are called optative type of sentence. So students, in this way we learn about the six type of sentences which is come in your syllabus, as well include in your chapter 1 various kind of sentences. Again, we do the quick revision of the sentence as well as the kind of sentence, that is what is sentence, a group of words which make complete sense, okay, and having a statement, having a meaningful thought. The sentence always begins with capital letter as well as ends with various punctuation mark. First thing is that. Second thing is that sentence having a six kinds. Number one, declarative. Declarative also called assertive, affirmative, simple. Okay? Declarative type of sentence having a simple statement which begins with a capital letter or ends with full stop. Second type of sentence is negative sentence. Negative sentence expressing any negative sense in any sentence by using the word not, no, never, forbid. When these words are included in any sentence, that type of sentences are called negative sentence. These sentence also begins with capital letter or ends with full stop. Third type of sentence, that is interrogative sentences. In interrogative sentences, we are asking the question to someone. These type of sentences begins with WH word as well as auxiliary verbs or ends with a question mark. Fourth type of sentences, imperative sentence. Imperative sentences expressing command, order, advice, suggestion or request. Beta, when you find the expression of command, request, suggestion, order in the sentence, these type of sentences are called imperative sentence. Imperative sentences also begins with capital letter or ends with full stop. Next type of sentence is exclamatory sentence. Exclamatory type of sentence expressing strong feeling. What type of strong sudden feeling is here? Sometime it should be happy or sad. Okay? These type of sentence contain a exclamation mark or having some words to expressing the feeling like hooray, oh no, oh, sorry, ah, alas. These type of words are using in exclamatory sentence. Now the last, optative type of sentence. In these type of sentences, we just find the expression of wish as well as curse. So students, today you just learn about the sentence as well as the various kinds of sentences. I hope you understand the topic. If you have any query regarding this topic, you have to write it in the comment box. I hope I will solve your problem. Okay, have a nice day. Bye-bye.